In the center of every massive galaxy, there's a supermassive black hole. And when I mean supermassive, that's what we actually call them. I mean, it's a million to a billion times the mass of our sun. And there seems to be one in the center of every big galaxy. And when these black holes are growing, they grow because gas is funneling around, sort of in a whirlpool, and falling into the black hole. The light that is generated in the gas falling into the black hole is so amazingly bright that it can outshine the trillions of stars in the host galaxy by 1,000 times. So that incredible power that comes out in light is actually so strong that it can blow gas out into the galaxy at speeds up to thousands of kilometers per second. Astronomy has really exploded in the past couple decades. We have access to these amazing facilities, so everyone knows about the Hubble Space Telescope. There's a Hubble Space Telescope in every wavelength of light, so there's also the Spitzer Space Telescope, the Chandra X-ray Observatory, and so we're able to look at the entire sky from in all different kinds of light. The other thing that astronomy does better than I think any science is that the community is very sharing, and so anytime the Hubble Space Telescope takes images from space, that data is put into an archive, and after a year, anyone in the world can look at that data. Every human is sort of interested in what the world is about and what the universe is like, and so there's this innate curiosity about what the world is like, and especially the extreme things. I have yet to meet a third grader who didn't think black holes were awesome. There are practical applications of astronomy research that are really unexpected, and that we are pushing the envelope in certain types of science. For example, the first X-ray detectors were launched in rockets to go above the atmosphere to look at X-rays from the sun. That same technology is what's being used in X-ray scanners today. We're also pushing the boundaries in computer science, because the data sets that you get from astronomy are absolutely enormous, and they just break all the codes that are out there. But those aren't what motivate people. People want to know what the universe is like. They want to understand what's going on. That's why they're doing it, and it turns out that solving those problems, you develop tools that are really powerful and useful in other completely unanticipated fields.